Hello everyone, welcome to Lukman IAS. Today we are going to have the Hindu analysis of 30th April 2021. So let us see which are the important articles in today's the Hindu newspaper. Yes, these are the important articles for mains purpose and for prelims purpose. And in the end, we have added some COVID-19 related developments at national level and international help to deal with COVID-19 pandemic in India. So let us take overview of all these articles first. To stop a third wave, India has to mask up. So the writer here is emphasizing on universal masking, and this is going to be our, we can say that, the important guard against the tackling third wave that India may face in near future. Okay, because the writer is very much pessimistic about the vaccination for the masses, that yes, the present government has rolled out the vaccination to all above 18 years, but because of demand supply mismatch, this will be a long term exercise, and that's why to stop the third wave, the masking is very important. So we are going to understand that from governance and COVID-19 perspective here. Then long and torturous. So the context here is about a recent conclusion of 8th phase of assembly election in West Bengal, and total assembly elections, the voting has been completed. So the article is talking about that aspect. Yes, and also free and fair elections, it's important for democracy, and the important unbiased functioning of constitutional bodies like Election Commission of India. There are some again allegations by the non-BJP party or non-ruling party against biased working of ECI, Election Commission of India. All these aspects we are going to understand here from polity and governance and COVID-19 perspective also. Now, specifically prelims related, China launches key module for its permanent space station. So from space science, space technology perspective, here we are going to take input specifically for our prelims examination. And lastly, some COVID-19 related developments at national stage and international help to deal with COVID-19 pandemic second wave in India. Okay, now let us go into details of all these articles. First article, to stop a third wave, India has to mask up. So on page number 6, editorial page, this article is very much emphasizing about the universal masking, hand hygiene, along with that the social distancing norms. All these are to be followed strictly by the people, so that yes, we know that the vaccine is the ultimate solution, but the vaccination of the masses is the long term, we can say, solution at present, looking at the level of, let's say, problems or challenges in rolling out all this vaccination and ensuring that vaccination to all people, right? So that's why mask wearing, physical distancing, hand hygiene, and ban on mass gathering. These 4 points are very important, 4 measures are very important, and to tackle with third wave that India may face in near future. Okay, so why the writer is talking about the third wave? Because all over the world, even Western countries like US, UK, and many European countries, they have faced the second wave. Along with that, the developing countries like Brazil, South Africa, they are also facing the third wave of COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so yes, in near future, after, let's say, this second wave recedes, in near future, India may face again the third wave of COVID-19 pandemic with new variants, new mutants in this virus. Okay, so yes, for that purpose, what we need to do is at present focus on mask wearing, physical distancing, hand hygiene, and ban on mass gathering. Because we know that yes, vaccination is the ultimate goal. Yes, vaccine are the best option, but given India's population, okay, so we know that around 1.3 billion population, a huge or humongous task before the government, slow pace of vaccination at present, then inelastic vaccine supplies both in India as well as globally, and limited finances with the state governments who have been recently given responsibility to give the vaccines to masses, especially the young population from 18 years to 45 years. right? So this is not going to happen quickly enough to stop the this as well as future waves of COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, so that's why the writer is focusing on mask wearing. Now he is also supporting with this particular, let's say, major with certain studies. For example, Bangladesh, one of the case study of Bangladesh is mentioned here in support of efficacy of these measures. Okay, so in Bangladesh there was let's say free distribution of these mask to the people, along with that well-designed instructional material as well as reminders from religious and community leaders and volunteers to the people. And this has led to tripling of use of mask. Mask usage tripled when such measures were taken. Okay, so this is how we have to understand the effectiveness of wearing of this mask. Now what happens in India, generally there is some kind of coercion. Okay, so coercive measures are taken on the people, like penalty, fine on not wearing mask or not properly wearing mask. This is how the state government, central government is approaching towards the universal masking in India at present. However, the importance of social influence and persuasion in asking people to wear mask is very important. For example, here religious and community leaders and volunteers, they are persuading people to wear the mask. They are asking people, it is of their benefit. They are explaining the importance or benefits of wearing mask, right? So this is how they are influencing the social behavior of the people. This is called as social influence and persuasion. And one of the important tool and technique is effective communication. Effective communication. So on behalf of the government or those important leaders, change agents in the society, like community leaders, or we can say religious leaders, actors, or we can say sports person, civil servants, or doctors, okay, so scientists, all they are, let's say, they should be equipped with well-designed instruction material, and they should be communicating this to the people. Yes. For example, a short video can be, let's say, made by all these personalities that can be, we can say, spread on the social media by the government itself on its own platforms. So this is going to communicate people. Along with that, whenever these change agents are in public domain, they are appearing in the public, they should be wearing masks. They should be continuously talking about importance of wearing mask. Okay, along with that, the people should be also persuaded to take the vaccine. So vaccine hesitancy, this should be removed from the country so as to deal with the more space of vaccination, we can say. The people should be taking vaccine at higher rate here. Okay, so yes, from governance perspective, to be well prepared with the third wave, to deal with third wave of COVID-19 pandemic, we should be prepared with well planned, we can say, roadmap with the government at present itself, right? So yes, accordingly you can take input here. Moving on, next article, long and torturous. Basically it is talking about the completion of assembly elections. Now the eighth phase of election, assembly election in West Bengal, recently concluded, and the counting of votes is going to happen on 2nd May for all assembly elections that happened in recent times. Okay, so the article is talking about that this was a very, let's say, daunting task. Along with that, it has also resulted into more and more infections, COVID-19 infections in that states. Okay, so that's why it has been also criticized and even warned by the state high courts. In for example, Madras High Court has also warned the Election Commission of India regarding taking measures in future Like recently, the ECI has taken measures like victory processions have been banned after counting of votes and declaration of results. At the same time, doubts over fairness and autonomy of election of Commission of India, these are continuously there even during this assembly election also. We have seen this in general elections to the Lok Sabha in 2019 also. Now also in assembly elections, what happened is ECI had made unprecedented seizures of cash and other items that were meant to be used to influence voters. However, the opposition parties have alleged that they were specifically targeted in such search operations. That means the constitutional bodies like ECI, basically they are not working in autonomous and fair manner when these allegations are taken into consideration. Okay, so what we need to understand here is free and fair and periodic elections are essential feature of democracy. Okay, along with that, it is also important tool with the government, for the people. Elections are the ultimate opportunity for the people to hold their elected representatives accountable, and that's why generally election cycles are not disturbed even during challenging situations that we have seen at present, COVID-19 pandemic. By denying the crisis in action and messaging, the political parties contributed to the current surge in infections. Okay, so the kind of, let's say, rallies were conducted in these states for assembly election campaigning by both ruling party as well as the opposition parties, and no social distancing measures, mask wearing measures, anything was observed. So this has resulted into COVID-19 surge of infections in these states. Considering the unprecedented situation of the pandemic, these elections should have been quick affair with limited campaigning. What happened was the exactly opposite. The massive rallies continued even after COVID-19 numbers began to grow exponentially. This is how the criticism of multi-phase elections, long elections in different phases is being criticized in recent times, and the ECI should reconsider such kind of multi-phase elections, especially during challenging times like COVID-19 pandemic. Right? So, yes, you can use these important, let's say, statements in your answers, features of democracy, free, fair, periodic elections. Along with that, these elections are the important opportunities in the hands of the people to hold the representatives accountable, right? So that's why we can understand that how elections are important, and that too, the fairness and autonomy of the Election Commission of India is very important. Okay, now moving on, specifically prelims related development. China launches key module for its permanent space station. Okay, so yes, name of the module, Tianhe, T-I-A-N-H-E, meaning the heavenly harmony. This name of the module, it blasted into space atop Long March 5B rocket. Okay, so this is going to be the first of 11 missions necessary to complete supply and crew the station by the end of next year at that space station. Okay, so you need to remember the probes and important modules that are sent by some of the specific countries. Which are these countries? First, US, NASA. Second, Europe, ESA. Third, Japan, JAXA. Fourth, China. Fifth, Russia. Roscosmos, the name here. And sixth, ISRO, India. So name of at least last 1 and 1.5 year, whatever the important probes and space missions sent by all these six is very important for our examination, science and technology. So try to remember this T and he. What kind of question we can expect here is specifically China related names can appear in the options. For example, recently the main module of China's first permanent space station was launched. Its name is, so like Tianwen, Cheng, Zhurong, these were also in news recently, but answer should be Tianhe, heavenly. Okay, so yes, others like Tianwen was recent Mars mission, Mars probe of China. Last year it was launched in July 2020. And on this Tianwen, this Zhurong rover is mounted. So after landing on Mars, this rover will be doing the research work. Okay, so name here is Zhurong, rover name. Now the Chang 5, basically this is the probe on sent on moon by China. This is sent on. Okay, so you need to remember the names. Basically Chang is for moon, Tianwen for Mars, and Tianhe recently launched, that is related to permanent space station of China, and Zhurong is name of rover that is mounted on Tianwen 1, right? So recent names, these are the names related to Chinese space missions. Try to remember them. Next, now the COVID-19 related developments at national stage. What are these developments? Yes, we know that recently Serum Institute of India has reduced the price of its Covishield vaccine for state governments. Similarly, now for Covaxin, Bharat Biotech also reduced the price for the state governments to 400 per dose. Earlier it was 600 per dose. This was earlier 600 per dose. And for SII, Covishield, it is reduced to 300 now per dose. Earlier it was 400. Earlier it was decided 400, now it is reduced to 300. Okay, other things like Delhi police dedicated a lane on the extreme left side of the road at a picket checking for ambulances to facilitate them as movement of emergency vehicles. So this is going to reduce the time limit for transfer of the patients to the hospitals. Okay, so this is good initiative by the Delhi police. Chief Justice of Madras High Court wondered what center was doing for past 12 to 14 months without anticipating the second wave of COVID-19 and getting prepared to face it. He also said that there could not be ad hoc approach to deal with pandemic. There should be a pre-plan prepared with the central government to deal with such kind of anticipated next waves of COVID-19 pandemic. Delhi High Court asked central government why states like Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra were allotted more oxygen than they asked for, while Delhi was not allotted its projected requirement to treat COVID-19 patients. Delhi projected demand was 700 metric tons. However, center allocated only 480 metric tons, and that too, this was not received by the Delhi government on daily basis, this much amount. So yes, these are the important developments at national level. Now international help has been receiving by the India. Recent times, two plane loads of COVID-19 supplies from Russia landed in Delhi, comprising ventilators, oxygen concentrators and medicines, including Russian made version of widely used drug Flavipir. Okay. US Agency for International Development announced that the world's largest military aircraft has left Travis Air Force base in California to Delhi. Okay, so it will be carrying supplies that included 440 oxygen cylinders donated by the state of California, 1 lakh N95 mask and 960,000 rapid diagnostic tests. This is the support from US and Russia that we are receiving at present. We will have follow up on next, let's say almost around 40 countries. Our foreign secretary has recently said that 40 countries are helping India in different manners in supplying oxygen cylinders, concentrators or containers, even the ready-made plants, for example, from the France we are importing. Along with that, mask and medical supplies, diagnostic kits and medicines are being supplied by these countries. Fine? Okay. So, important captions and quotations. Just now we talked about this. The free and fair and periodic elections, important for democracy and important for holding representatives accountable. So, you can use that in GS2 paper, polity part or related essay topic. Polity and governance. And then the viruses are most basic organisms, and often basic changes in human behavior can drastically reduce the ability of virus to transmit. So you can use this as conclusion to simply any health related question in GS2 paper, COVID-19 related or science related, okay, or we can say that essay on COVID-19. In this, you can use such kind of statements. Fine? Okay. So, yes, these were important articles from today's The Hindu newspaper. For further information on editorial discussion classes or AD classes, wherein in-depth analysis of mains related issues and articles is done by Ansari sir, you can contact Lukman IS. Thank you.